Philippine economic managers lower the country's growth targets for this year and the next. The National Economic Development Authority says it expects the country's GDP to settle between 6 to 7% in 2024 and between 6.5 to 7.5% in 2025. This comes after Manila missed its economic growth target last year.
The revised targets for our headline indicators considered the country's recent economic performance in fiscal year 2023 and reflect the latest developments and expectations on external factors such as global demand and trade growth, oil price movements, and expected exchange rate and inflation trends. These growth targets will sustain the country's position as one of the fastest growing emerging economies in the Asia-Pacific region. Moreover, at this pace of growth, we are still on track to achieving or to reducing poverty incidence from 18% in 2021 to single digit level in 2028.
The inflation target for the next 4 years, though, was retained at 2 to 4% even after consumer prices broke a four-month deceleration streak in February. Official inflation numbers for March will be released tomorrow, Friday. The damage brought by the El Nino weather phenomenon to the Philippine crop sector further swells to 2.63 billion pesos. The Agriculture Department adds over 54,000 farmers are now affected by the dry spell. On Wednesday, the agency rolled out over 1 billion pesos in aid for affected farmers.
Pero kung ikukumpara natin ito doon sa mga previous El Nino episode na damage, napakababa pa nito. Halimbawa, noong strong El Nino episode noong 1997-1998, umabot sa 370,000 hectares yung naapektuhan nitong strong El Nino na ito. Ngayon, ang naapektuhan sa atin in terms of area ay 34,000. Totally damaged is 9,000 hectares. Yung partially naman is only about 25,000. Still can recover. Less than 2% ito ng total area planted natin.
Searing heat forces Zamboanga City to suspend classes in all levels. The city now facing as well a water shortage. Our very own Queenie Casimiro now joins us with that story. Queenie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, classes in all levels, both in public and private schools in Zamboanga City, are suspended today and tomorrow. The local government unit announced a suspension Wednesday afternoon after members of the local task force El Nino convened to discuss about the public clamor for class suspension amid the rising heat index felt throughout the city. The Department of Education also announced today the shifting of on-site classes to alternative delivery mode, either for distance learning, modular or online, in compliance with DepEd Order No. 37 in relation to the heat index experienced by the city. Mayor Jan Dalipe is also set to issue an executive order to be concurred by the Sangguniang Pandungsod, granting authority to school heads to suspend classes if the heat index breaches 40 degrees Celsius. Throughout the country, Zamboanga City registered the highest heat index on March 31 and April 2 at 43 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees heat index yesterday. In a resolution filed by the Task Force El Nino, it also ordered the implementation of flexible working hours for persons with disabilities, pregnant and lactating mothers, and others with comorbidities in all local and national government offices in the city. Meanwhile, the prolonged dry spell has brought the water level at the city's reservoir to below normal up to critical levels. Thus, water rationing continues to be implemented in the city. Since February this year, most areas are given water supply only every other day. In Barangay Santa Catalina, for example, residents are seen queuing at the barangay hall with their pails and other containers every night. Raden Basaludin says this has become their daily activity since they cannot afford to not have water supply in a day for bathing, cleaning, and other purposes. They buy potable water separately. Three water tanks were given by the LGU to Santa Catalina, which are being filled with water by the City Disaster Risk Reduction Management Office every afternoon. Barangay Chair Jordan Evangelista says residents of nearby barangays can also get water from them for free. This scenario is common in many barangays in the city, especially those located in elevated areas where the water district can no longer service due to low water supply and low water pressure. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Queenie Casimiro there joining us on the line.